game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Coach Mujib, very good afternoon to you. Welcome to the coaching exclusive interviews we usually have here. Quick one, let's start with your footballing career before you became a coach during your footballing journey.
My football journey is quite long, but not so packed. I started playing football as early as I was in primary three. I remember Chibuli Demonstration School, which was a very footballing school at the moment. And then Chibuli Senior Secondary School, where I made a big part of my name. And later I joined Kofi Sports Club in 1994 as a 15-year-old. After that, I joined KCC in 1996. And I played until 1999. Then I went to the US on a football scholarship for Alabama A&M University. I came back here in 2003, played again for KCC and the Uganda national team until 2006 when I retired from active football.
Obviously, when you mention Kofi Sports Club, I think it kind of reminds me of the first club side that won the Kakungulu Cup way back, if my memory serves me right. But quickly, let's talk about the FIFA resignation. What were the reasons behind it? Because according to some reports way back, you could have been or could have been the FUFA president back then, a couple of years back.
The reason why I resigned from the FUFA vice presidency was due to the fact that that same year my team Proline was relegated. And because the team was relegated, I could no longer represent the Super League clubs in the FUFA executive. Remember, I was vice president in charge of the league. Now, I couldn't be in charge of a league where my team was not playing. So because of that, I decided to resign and let the league people take care of themselves.
That's it. So it was nothing political?
No, it wasn't political. It wasn't political, yes.
Quickly on to when you started coaching, when you did your coaching badges at the time, what was that like for you?
It was easy because I started to do my coaching badges when I was in the university. It was quite easy because I was in mainstream academics, so doing the badges was quite easy. It helped me to do them when I was still young. It is difficult when you do them later, but for me it was smooth sailing all through.
Coach Kasule, you've been known to groom players. I remember in 2005 I was one of the kids that joined Proline at the time, and you had partnership with Rio Ferdinand's dad at the time. Is it something that you've come up with, not just back then? Is it something that you're looking into as part of your long-term projects for Proline?
Yes, for me, I base my footballing business and work and philosophy on the youth. I believe without the youth, there is nothing in the world without the youth that can prosper. Here in Uganda, for long, we have neglected the youth. We have only looked at the top. I keep asking myself, where are those players playing in the national team coming from? And for me, it's important that we address the beginning of the pipeline, not the middle or the end. So for me, working with the youth is my passion. I love that, and I like to do that. All my partners that I work with, you've mentioned Rio Ferdinand and his family, Anton and the dad, Julian, have always come in to help, and they are always going to continue helping us as long as we are in this project. And hopefully, our efforts can start to reap results for Uganda national team.
There's been a couple of reports about you being a scout, and if that is actually true, if there's any truth in that, have there been any players that have come through your hands as far as professional football is concerned?
Yes, in football I've done everything. So I have been a player, I have been a football journalist, I've written articles, I've had columns, I've worked on TV, you know, as a pundit. So I've done it all. I was the first FIFA agent not only in Uganda, but in Eastern Central Africa. I resigned from that when I started owning a club because the rules would not let me do that. So I have done that. I have done a bit of scouting for teams and for clubs. I do consultancy, so I've done it all. Many players have gone through my hands, but the ones that stand out, the boys I started the academy with, notably Ivan Bukenya, who has played in Iraq, played with KZ Chiefs in South Africa, now is playing in India. Sula Matovu also played in Iraq. K the Chiefs now is playing with the Royal Eagles in South Africa. The biggest one now is Alex Kakuba, who is playing in the Premier League in Portugal with Estoril, but loaned now to Firenze at the moment. We have Mike Azira. These are the boys we started with. Now he's in MLS in the US. Talk about Edema Patrick, he's playing in Portugal. Apollo Razak is playing in Portugal. Butela Andrew is playing with APR in Rwanda. Charles Tibingana is playing in South Africa, in Thailand. So the list is long, and this, all this has happened recently. We just sent Lubega Drissa to Austria. So the list is long, but we just hope to continue making it longer and longer, because it's the only way Uganda will benefit.
You talk about Idrissa Lubega, one of the finest strikers that have gone through your hands, and probably one of the top goal-scoring strikers in your club side, Proline. How much of a gap does this, you know, leave your club side, and does this kind of pave way for the likes of Nelson Senkatuka?
Yes, we believe that if a player gets an opportunity to go somewhere where he's going to improve his career, at the same time improve his economic status, we let them go. We don't even think about it. We don't think about the team at that moment, because we believe we have many players in the pipeline, in the team, in the academy, that can only replace them. And we've been vindicated, because since Lubega left, the team has improved better than it was when he was here. Not to take anything away from him, but the boys that have come up, especially Nelson, he stepped to the plate and he's filled the gap quite well. You know, he's playing better. He's scoring goals and creating just as many. And the other boys who have also come into the team, Bayo Fahad, every time he's called upon, he's done brilliantly, which is a testimony to how we train these boys and how focused they are. In case one gets injured or leaves the club, the ones that have been the understudy, they can come in and do just as good. And so far, we are very happy with the way it's going.
Let's talk about this boy's mission, Fahad in there, Chintu as well, Gift Ali, the skipper, the goalkeeper, Sadie Kenny. These are all young players. Is this something Proline is advocating in terms of they're choosing to go in for a younger version compared to the likes of AC Villa, KCCA, who are filled with literally veterans? Is this something that Proline will implement even in the future?
Yes, we had to forget for two things. And these are things we didn't see in the Ugandan game. And Proline, we are happy to introduce them. Number one, in football, if a kid is very good, he's old enough. Secondly, we need to produce players that can be able to go to Europe and fit in. Not go to Europe and get sent back for failing a trial because they cannot fit in. Then thirdly, and most importantly, the Ugandan game is beginning to, for a long time, they've been ignoring talented players. They are looking for aggressive players, players with a lot of work rate, players who can be very physical, and they are ignoring the talented players who are the creative players. Now, you cannot win leagues or tournaments or even qualify consistently for major tournaments without these kinds of players. These are the players that people come to see, the likes of Gift Ali. You see the way he uses the ball, you see the way he plays. He's effective, but at the same time, he's entertaining. And all the other boys, and even Nelson, when he came to us, we tried to make him do exactly the same. Play well, entertain, at the same time be effective. So these are the things that we want to introduce to the game. We want other clubs to benchmark from us, because like I said earlier, without the youth, in anything you do in this world, without the youth, you will never be successful. Ugandan football needs to give opportunities to the youth, because there are so many youth, there are so many young boys who are very good, but their progress has been hindered due to the fact that clubs do not trust them that they can play. But the few that have been given an opportunity recently, you've seen Okello with KCC, you know, he comes on, he can play. You've seen Nurdin Bunju with Proline, Joshua Kirol, you know. These boys are just as good, and they should be given an opportunity when they are still young. Because if you look at the world over, Messi was a world star at 16, Fabregas the same, Rooney was the same, Ronaldo, you know. So we need to start believing and be confident and give these boys an opportunity. And the opportunity means put them in there, have belief in them, at the same time be patient with them, because they will make mistakes, but doesn't mean giving a match once. So we need to start thinking along those lines.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports.